What's up, everyone? I'm Easton Groves, and right now I'm back in the Spider Farmer 4x4 that's lighted by the G5000. This is Spider Farmer's newest bar style light that's foldable. Dimmer's in a new spot, but aside from that, I had a comment on this video that really actually caught my eye and really got me interested in the power output of this light itself. That's from, let's see if I can remember. Was it Chili and Spice and All Things Nice? They left a comment asking if I could check the power output at the plug. So I did, over the weekend, purchase a plug-in power energy meter. So this, I can check the wattage, kilowatt hours, amperage, voltage, and it can also run cost, but I don't really care about that. So it's kind of curious at different settings on the dimmer, what power output am I actually getting? So right now I'm sitting at 11%. And it is putting out 64.6 watts. And that is only 0.59, it's half an amp. So that's at 11%, and 11% is the lowest setting for this light. And actually all of the G series and SE series only go to 11%. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna check it at 25, 50, 75, and 100%. That way I pretty much hit all ranges. And I'm not only gonna do it to this light in this video, I'm also gonna do it to my SE5000 and my 5x5. So this is the older style SE7000. And this light right here has got a power output of 700 watts, where the G5000 is 480 watts. So go ahead and move this up to 25%. There we go. And 25% is putting out 134.8 watts at 1.11 amps. Just a little over 1 amp. All right, 50%. Is putting out 256.7 watts and 2.12 amps. Da, 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 50, 75. I hate these LED displays trying to get it on camera, but you get to just 75%. 385.3 watts at 3.19 amps. And of course, 100. So 495 watts at 4.12 amps. So on this website, Spider Farmer has this G5000, let me turn this down now, rated at a 480 watt light. It's putting out 494 watts. So Spider Farmer did underrate this light when making the advertisement. So you're getting a little bit more power output than what is advertised. It's not much, probably won't make too big of a difference, but it is a little bit more. So they have underrated their lights when they go to sell you through their advertising. So that is the G5000. This is their affordable, their more affordable bar style light. It is made with Bridgelux diodes instead of the Samsung Evo diodes. So it does make it a little bit less cost effective. I will put the price on screen. I don't have it off the top of my head right now, but I think this is $396. So not a bad price for a really good quality bar style light. Now the SE7000 at its lowest rating. Let me grab the wattage tester and see where it sits. Up real quick. Ugh. Y'all get to go along for the whole installation ride. There we go. All right. So right now, it's showing that the light is pulling 92.9 watts at the lowest setting for the SE7000. And that is 0.82 amps. So I need something to stand on. So I can actually see the dimmer. Because this is, like I said, they're old style. And the dimmer's attached to the ballast. We'll move this to 25%, which I'm going to say at the angle I'm looking at is about right there. Yeah, that looks good to me. Right now that is putting out 166.3 watts at 1.3 amps. Oh, I should have lowered this light for this. Whatever. That should be 60%. I'll say 50 is about right there. Maybe, maybe not. So that is 294.5 watts at 2.44 amps. Hate wearing glasses. I'd say 75 is about right there, because 80% is not too far off. That's 472.7 watts at 3.94 amps. Where you at? And 100%. 100% is putting out 722.3 watts at 6.05 amps. So 720 watts on Spider Farmer's website, this light is rated at 700 watts. So again, they have actually undersold their light, which is actually a good thing. I mean, think about it. What if they didn't undersell the light? What if they said it had the exact 721 or 724 watts, and then it was wrong? I mean, who knows? But it's good that they were willing to undersell the light a few watts than to sit there and give you a light that is not actually putting out the proper wattage. That's a really good light. I just wish it was foldable, but like I said, this is the old style where it had a solid support bar on both sides. And as you saw, the dimmer is attached to the ballast. But it works, serves its purpose. I've had it for a year now. Absolutely knocks it right out of the park. So let me go run inside and I will check the G4500. All right guys, this beautiful light right here that we're looking at is the G4500 from Spider Farmer. So this light right here is the three bar style light that is meant for 2x4 tents. Practically, I'm gonna say side to side coverage. And you might be losing 2 inches on the front, 2 inches on the back. But other than that, you do have a bar style light that will work for your 2x4. And so this is the G4500. And this is a better look from the G5000 as the new location for the dimmer itself. And you can, if you need to, or want to, you can remove the dimmer from its location. Now, you can't disconnect it from the ballast. It is still connected to the ballast in a sense of a wire, but you could take it off and mount it somewhere else if you really wanted to. And you're not working with much. So, you can only move it over here, so I don't really know why you'd want to do that with it just mounting right there, but either way, let's go ahead and get it set to manual, turn it to 11%. So this is the lowest setting for this G4500, just like the G5000. And wattage, 42.6 watts, 0.35 amps. And I do hope y'all can hear me with the fans that I do have on in this tent. I do have a grow, as you can see right there, currently going, which is Moneyball. And if you're just watching and tuning into the channel, go check that grow out and the grow before that, which is Magic Candy Mountain. That I knocked that grow out of the park. But moving on, set this thing at 25%. And it is putting out 86.2 watts at 0.71 amps. But yeah, go check out the Magic Candy Mountain OG Grow, which was the season right before this. And check out the other three videos that are out for this grow. That way you can catch up on it. But I don't want to show too much of the plants because I don't want this video right here to get demonetized. But we are at 50% right now. And that is putting out 167.2 watts at 1.38 amps. Oop, wrong way. That's 75. We're looking at 252.8 amps at 252.6 watts at 2.09 amps. And 100%. 331.3 watts at 2.74 amps. So that right there is your wattage and amperage for each light that I own. So if there's any other lights that Spider Farmer plans to send me for any kind of reviews or unboxing, oops, then I will do more. But until then, I don't need to purchase any other lights. So these are the only three lights that I will be doing. And if you do have a SF2000 light and want me to do the same thing for that light, let me know in the comments and I'll drop that in a separate video on itself, since it is a board style light, not a bar style light. And I kind of want to keep them separate. But guys, that's your wattage and amperage for all three lights, the G4500, the G5000, and the SE7000. If you like what you see, head on over to spider-farmer.com. Use code EASTONGROWS. You'll save 8% at checkout. And as always, guys, thanks for watching. What I'll say at the end of an equipment video now, because I got happy growing for the plants. I got stay infused for the bong and dab reviews. Stay techie. I don't know. Let me know in the comments. What do y'all want to hear at the end of an equipment review video? Later, guys.